How's everybody doing? Grab that cable real quick. What up, Miss Innocent? Do you hear the rumble sound effect? Let's get it on. It's all right. It's all right. How's everybody going? You guys hear my sound effects at all when I did It's Ready to Rumble? Up. Do you hear the game? I don't know what I'm doing in this game. That's the funny thing. First time playing this game. Let's do this. I'm playing an old one. Let's go, people. Let's go, people. It's going good. It's going good. How you doing? Ah. What up, Roy? What are you doing? What are you doing? What up, Roy? I haven't streamed in forever. I'm trying to get everything the way I want it. I don't know if any of my stuff's working. I don't know if you can hear the game. You having a good day, Roy? I guess I should have looked up the controls of this game before I played it. You guys hear the game though? we're gonna do W. What's going on, guys? You guys can't hear the audio from the game at all. I don't know what's going on with that. Figure this out. I gotta sit here and figure this out because you guys aren't getting any sound whatsoever. So I have no clue why that's not working at all. Let's get it on. Let's get it going. Let's see if you guys get something on that one. I don't know. We'll find out.
That time, 75-yard drive, 5.
There we go. It ends with a Denver touchdown. Now you guys are getting Brandon voice.
Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. On the return, Corey Ballantyne. And able to get this out to the 25.
Let's do it, baby.
Here now comes the Jets offense, and the man that will be captaining the ship at 6'3", it's Sam Darnold.
I love how he exploded on the national scene his redshirt freshman year when, at the beginning of the season, he was not named the starting quarterback. But when USC was struggling, he got an opportunity. And by the end of the year, the Rose Bowl MVP, an epic shootout with Penn State, and put him on the NFL radar in a big way.
Now the forward Terrapin, this is Ty Johnson.
And this will what be a game of five. How's everybody doing tonight? You got work there, 5 yards, or you getting on here in a little bit?
First down, that brings up second and five.
Game of five brings up second and five at the 30-yard line.
The shotgun snap for Darnold.
Oh, man, I missed him.
Dancing to his left. And he's going to keep it here.
Damn it, I messed up that one.
Darnold on the keeper.
What are you doing, Roy? You working or are you home with the baby and the wife?
First down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Let's get it going.
Play action. It's Darnold. He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe bring your running back.
There we go, baby. There we go.
Down he goes again.
Sam Darnold.
But this is what happens when you get behind the chains, as people like
oh,
to say.
Oh, Roy, you must have gotten off the start of the screen.
Situations, hard to vary it up and fool a defense.
And you hate those situations if you're an O-lineman, right?
Oh, without a doubt, because you just know they're coming, and you never know exactly how. They can be exotic in their blitzes, or their athletic ability just takes over.
There we
and
go.
He's going to go down again.
Miller.
Von Miller. That's now back-to-back sacks, and it brings up fourth down. And that is the third sack this offensive
line. Now that's a pro gamer move.
Man, that puts him on pace. Let me do the rudimentary math here. To be sacked 12 times in a game, I know he's not going to go for that. I wonder if it's going to reshape what they decide to do on offense in terms of play calling.
Well, I can tell you what, when he popped up, shaking his head, frustrated right now behind center.
That didn't do very good.
Very good return that time. 18 yards.
Miss Innocent.
Broncos take over. First down.
What's going on? How's the bike going?
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown.
Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now defensively, you've almost got to get down into those starters' blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
And that one falls incomplete. A 50-50 ball. A little dangerous. Could have been picked. Now it's third down. He's going to take another shot here. That's caught inside the 20. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Jake Butt, 58 yards.
That's how we do it, baby. That's how we do it.
It's not much as perfect in football. That's about as close to it as you're going to get. Score, force a punt, score again.
And both
over
his head
behind
it. Now on the other side, though, what's your psyche? You're really behind the eight ball.
You got to make sure you just hold in there. Survive the early storm. Relax a little bit. And try and get back to your game plan. It's way too early for panic.
McManus's point after is good. And it's now 14 to nothing.
What up, Brittany? How you doing? You're playing too. You guys just went live. Or are you guys with Roy live?
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Fielded near the back of the end zone, and Ballantyne gonna sit on this one.
Yeah, Cowboys aren't playing. Broncos.
Back onto the field come the New York Jets for their second drive. They've been outplayed early, no question.
Dallas Cowboys. 14-0 already.
As they come up first and 10. First carry here for Frank Gore. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
The jet ball carrier.
So you're down
early. Looking good.
How do you get back in the game? Maybe establish the run. I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one. And what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator, let's run the football. Let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
Let's get it done. Get it done. Get it done. Go.
From the 30 on second down, Darnold, his throw incomplete. He was trying to find his tight end, Chris Herndon, but now it'll be third down. Darnold now to throw. And it's caught by Herndon. And he lost the football. It's picked up by the Broncos.
Hell yeah.
And he'll get this back to
the
32-yard line.
Baby.
Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football, and they still find ways to knock it free.
Got a man open. It's Sutton. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
And at the 11-yard line.
On first down, Locke.
Incomplete.
They couldn't hook up on what's going to be the final play of this first quarter. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Heather can subscribe.
Left side here, that's the tight end fan. And the Broncos are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Locked on target to Fant for a Bronco first down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
That's caught at the 3. And he'll take it into
barely walked in that one. Oh, my God.
Noah Fant on the touchdown pass from Drew Locke. And the Broncos push further out in front. So simple math here in the first half. They've had 3 drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well,
whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
Extra point from McManus is good. It's now 21-0.
For Denver.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away.
Who's all up in chest still? Who's just got me tapped?
And this carries into the end zone. And Ballantyne going to sit on this one. That'll be a touchback.
Yeah, you should.
Kapow. Subscribe. Of our player spotlight. And I guess the question,
money,
keeping him better protected, because as we see, the protection, it struggled.
And normally what you get is renewed determination. When the big guy gets hit, that usually sparks people. Hey, we can't let this happen anymore. They take it personally. He's not supposed to be on the ground. But that hasn't been the case so far in this game. So maybe they've got to figure out how do they get rid of the ball faster to help out the offensive line so he doesn't get hit as much.
And we'll see if they can keep him off the ground now going forward. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
It's a pickup of six. Brings up second and four.
Darnold from the gun. Open man is Denzel Mims. And they get him down before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down.
When you're struggling at all, you're looking for anything possible.
Got a new child subscriber going on here. We are kicking ass. Keith. Go. Thank you for the subscription.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Heath, not Heath. I don't know. I'm not confused.
Officially
Heath,
nothing
not
on that last run. Heath. They'll try again. Heath. Second and 10. They'll fake the handoff. Now Darnold. And the Broncos get there and take him down.
There we go.
Picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
I'm starting to feel bad. Heather. Back back there. I mean, you
Heather.
Know me.
Heather.
I don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. Darnold and the Jets come up third and long following the sack. Out of the shotgun, here's Darnold. He finds his target. It's Crowder.
Oh, they got it.
And he is going to have a Jets first down.
He's
able to get the third down conversion. Boy, a nice
you see my
play
new shirt?
There
I put it on after I take a shower. It's
going to
be my shirt tomorrow. Molly Banks.
And I don't think there's any question that this offense is going to need to hit on a few more plays like this. It's been a difficult first half for them, to say the least. And I do believe if they want to get back in this game, they need to start right now. It's kind of like making adjustments. If you try and wait until the half, it's probably too late. They need to get going right here.
You can barely hear me.
Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it.
Is that better? Can you hear me now?
So the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run. But the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less.
Much better. You hear the game audio too?
7 yards there and a first down.
New York.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football.
Cool. You hear all the sound effects?
Now that's a program of news.
Jonathan Coachman will be alongside. He'll have highlights and analysis from Orlando of this first half of action. Darnold throwing complete to Crowder, and he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down.
You always worry about those smaller receivers running through that gnarly patch of land in the middle of the field. But he did a really nice job there holding on to the football and protected himself as best he could while completing the play.
Completing it to the right side, Johnson. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down.
Usually the offense has an answer to anything a defense throws at them, including a safety valve. And that's what they did on that play. They went there, but the defense still made an excellent play and held them to no gain.
Let's get it on.
Throwing again on second down.
Ooh,
Darnold.
Got it.
Popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by Alexander Johnson. And a big turn.
We're going to get it. We're going to get it.
Guys will get the football back.
Well, there definitely was some juice on that pass.
This is only got two viewers.
Always have the same reputation for hands as wide receivers do. In this case, that ball was expected to be caught.
Let's do some Hail Marys. See what we can get.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. After the turnover, here's Locke. He'll let this go deep for Sutton. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
Let's get her on.
In this first half, and they get a measure of revenge there. Nice play on the deep ball.
Yeah, they're gonna need a few more plays like that in order to get their confidence fully back.
There we go. There we go. Work it.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question: do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
Throwing his lock on third down.
Oh,
damn it.
That might be the third down stop that they needed, because they've had a lot of trouble slowing down this offense in the first half. This might be their opportunity to get off the field.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on four. He'll fire one downfield for Fant.
Oh, damn it. They're going to get me. Going to get me.
Scratcher there. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone.
I don't know why that was. It's almost guaranteed points the other way. I mean, I get it if it's a late game situation, maybe even fourth and inches.
All right, there's going to get him money.
It's a huge risk to take.
Yeah, now they're set up in prime position going the other way. Flushed out right. And all the way down inside.
It's not going to be good. Not going to be good. I wanted this to be a shutout. Not going to happen after that. I screwed up that one bad.
With a little over 50 seconds to go in the first.
Let's get her done.
This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score.
Now you got my emotes.
That's caught. Hit the three. And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. Darnold to his tight end, Chris Herndon on the touchdown.
The little smiley thing down at the bottom. You have my emotes because you're a subscriber.
Camp. Do you remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring and land.
So the challenge comes in inside of 2 minutes. And it gets overturned.
And it changes the whole format of what's about to happen, because both sides had thought a certain call had been made. Now they have to flip back and start over.
Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal.
I would have to stretch for this one. This is four down territory. They've got to get it in with the deficit that they're facing.
Absolutely. It's not the fourth quarter, but still, I think you can't be thinking three here.
No, if you do that, you might as well go ahead and fold up on this one, but I don't think they're built like that.
They'll try and push it in with Gore. He is going nowhere as he is enveloped by.
Let's get her done.
No gain on the play, and what to do now on fourth. Defense didn't budge on third down. Now what are we going to see on fourth?
We are soon to find out, but does this feel like old school football or what?
Oh, yeah.
This is old fashioned.
Oh, I have a tier one subscription. You're good. There should be one in there.
Some type of a play where my quarterback has a chance to run it or throw it. I don't just want one static play.
An 18-yard attempt.
Oh, wow. It's not going to be a shutout now. Damn it. I was trying to get the shutout.
Deficit drops now from 21 down to 18. First half facing this deficit, but at least they did put three on the board before half.
Yeah, it's a little bit like that stormy, cloudy day.
There you go.
The sun peeks through in the second. They saw the sun there. They're hoping to see a little bit more of it in the second half.
Taking it about the one.
There you go. You got laugh out loud.
So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you on out to our studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman and REA Sports Halftime, an abbreviated halftime show as we get rolling to quarter three.
Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
Let's get her going. You hear the music in the background?
Taken about 7 yards deep, and Ballantyne gonna sit on this one. That'll be a touchback.
Let's get her done. I'm tired today.
New York gets set to take over. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score.
Yeah, I figure out how to change. What is it? Controller. No, I don't want that one. I want settings. There we go. No, I don't want that one either. Or F. Okay.
Seven, past the 30 to the 32. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards at first down, that fits the bill.
I had to figure out what key to press.
Again, as his nightmare afternoon continues.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
I don't know, I'm more tired. Well, maybe. I take that back. You could be.
In desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. And they'll run the option on third and short yardage. Darnold, he lost the football. The Broncos say they have it. They do.
Ooh, fumble, baby. That's how we do it, baby.
So now we'll look at the Broncos as they head back out there for their first possession of the second half. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board. Got a man, it's caught at the 6 yard line.
Ooh. 31.
Just shy of the 5 at the 6.
Well, he's definitely a big target out there, listed as 6'4", and he used every one of those extra inches to go up and make that catch.
And this is caught by Sutton. Touchdown.
Got it. We're going to get that.
Touchdown pass. And the fumble and turn it into 6. He was on point throwing the ball right there. He had the big play to get him down close, and then he delivers a touchdown pass on first and goal.
And you mentioned the big play that got him down close. I think that big play left him reeling a little bit. They didn't recover from it. And you know, they always talk about having to have a short memory on defense after a big play against you.
Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Taken in the end zone. And Ballantyne going to sit on this one. That'll be a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
And now out come the Jets. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over. The other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. Here's Darnold. Rolling to his right. He'll try and run it. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And they worked this well.
I messed up on that one. Messed up on that one.
Space there, picking up the out of a 21-yard game.
Partner, it's often the man coverage is easier for a quarterback to run against. You get your receivers going downfield,
Those guys are staying with them, and oftentimes they have their back to the quarterback, which opens up a lot of space and room, and they don't even know that he's taken off with it. What a big time.
He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. Von Miller able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third.
Gotta get the baby.
Turn into a long game or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points. And the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball.
Darnold, and he'll get up near the.
We got three viewers. What's up, three viewers?
3 yards, all they could muster there, and it'll bring up fourth.
Defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Here's the Jets punter now, as he'll kick it away for the second time.
Let's get her done.
He'll send this one into the mile high air, and it's a good one.
Not gonna get that.
Spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. So the Broncos coming out now. They have picked up right where they left off in half number one.
Just to get her done.
Really dominant, extending this lead.
And it's fun to see when teams actually do that, because so many times you go into the half after playing well and you kind of relax.
Why is it giving me this?
A little bit. We've got this. We can kind of punch the button whenever we get good and ready. But for a team to keep the intensity and keep the execution up and come back after the half and play so well, that's actually really, really nice to see.
And a pedal to the metal. That's what we're seeing right now. They look to throw. It's Locke. And that's complete. Albert Okwuegbunam. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
Oh, too early. Damn it. I meant to hit the other button. Gotta get it down.
And that'll bring up second down.
When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think they'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
DP goes into Jets territory before being taken down. Good. What a huge play there for Denver. 51 yards.
Well, Bart, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
Field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Oh, he bowls over him. The quick slam caught. This will be stopped about 2 yards.
They weren't watching that, baby. They weren't watching that.
And a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker. And you've got to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest worry? Ball is tipped in the air. Because if that happens, then it's fair game.
Oh, fuck. I fucked that one up.
This will be caught just inside the 10. Give him a loss of 6 yards, and it brings up third down.
Behind the line of scrimmage.
You can tell I'm not a gamer for this.
To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he just... Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to
throw. Oh, they got me.
They're not going to get it. They try to move the chains with a surprise, but it's a turnover.
I couldn't get it.
They pass up the...
I'm not doing good on that one.
It doesn't work. And the Jets
are... I needed to do a quick flop out on that one.
Here's the Jet offense. Now they head out to take over. And with this deficit... You can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here?
doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him. All right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. There's got to be casualties at times.
What are you guys doing? Anybody doing anything?
His way forward and get what he can.
Second and 10 now. Third quarter action in Denver. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play.
All right, good night.
Has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Here's second and 10. Back to throw, Darnold. Able to connect with Mims. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
It's a gain of 10. First down, Jets.
Darnold. He's got Herndon, his tight end.
Darnold, 7 yards, the pickup.
They're getting it good.
You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath.
What are they, how are they getting through this defense all of a sudden?
Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and lead the game out that way.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3. Here's Darnold. Throwing right, and that's complete.
Damn it. I keep getting completions.
Down.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard. It's a give him 9 there on the first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and 1. Darnold completes it. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
First down, New York.
Darnold to throw again. Crowder's got it over the middle. And this will leave him a yard short.
Not doing good on this one.
9 yards on first down. A gain of give him 9 there on the first down completion.
At the 25-yard line.
Looking to throw again on second down.
That's what I like to see. Too much pressure. Too much pressure. Can't do it. Can't do it.
Quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
The Jets on third down. They've had their troubles. Just 1 for 6. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Again, Darnold. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And he returns it up just shy of the 20 to the 19-yard line.
I'm not sure, Brandon, we've seen a sloppier played game this year for a team on offense. Turn it over 4 times and expect to win? No chance whatsoever. And look, I have no idea what the ratio is about turnover 4 times and how that correlates.
Let's do some Hail Marys, guys.
I guarantee you, it's not very good.
Let's do it. Let's do a fucking Hail Mary. Oh, we got over there. We got Q.
First and 10 at their own 19-yard line. He's back to throw here to start the drive. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Let's get it. Let's go a different Hail Mary.
That'll bring up second down. Throwing now is Locke. They'll fire one downfield for Fant. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way. Whoop, whoop.
Let's go. Let's go, guys.
Big play late here for offense. Charles has certainly has had its fair share of big plays.
Coverage has been a problem all game long, and I would say that going along with that has been confidence, because even if they had the right coverage, they've still dented them, and now it's been a real issue for them during this game.
What the fuck, dude? You weren't there.
Up to be incomplete. He was trying to hit Melvin Gordon there. And now it's second down.
Leads to second and 10.
Throwing again. Block. There goes a deep ball. End zone. And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown.
And they just continue to roll. And Charles, for you and I, we want the close games, but for them, it has to be so nice to enjoy this big cushion.
I can't remember the last time we saw them play this loose and have this much fun. I think they'd love to be able to capture this game.
Let's go, people.
From week to week and be able to execute like this in all the rest of their games.
Everybody doing okay?
Taken about 7 yards deep. And Ballantyne going to sit on this one. That'll be a touchback.
25-yard line.
Now the Jets offense gets ready to head back on the field.
Let's go. Let's finish this game, finish the stream, get it done. That's the way we got to do it.
That's what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? Does that change what you do?
I think it does, depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play. So you
freaking hungry, guys.
If it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try to take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5. The shotgun snap for Darnold. Throw complete to Herndon. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. The start for them near flawless. Defense gets them a 3 and out. 2 quick pass connections on offense.
So that's how a team works together. Just what you described. Get them the ball, give them a little momentum, and they're capitalizing off of that. Thanks a lot, guys.
Darnold's throw taken in by Mims. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You tackle them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
And he's out of bounds. Just
I should have had that guy.
Field stripe at the 49.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit because earlier in the game, I think he's trying to force a lot of throws into some windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception. Really a bad throw, so maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
Other than that one,
this has been a rough one to put it mildly for him.
He didn't learn on that one at all.
I just feel like at the post-game press conference, this team's going to have a lot of questions and definitely not a lot of answers.
Oh, God damn it.
He's got a first down and then some inside the 40.
Screwed that one up bad.
But not before he's inside the 30. Nowhere to go downfield, but he's able to get out of bounds and stop the clock here with a first down.
Sometimes guys get locked into such a groove. What do we call it? The game slowing down. They see everything happening almost in slow motion. They see the lanes develop. I feel like he's right there.
Well, and you want this from your leader, right? With this deficit, this stage of the game, second half, no quit in him.
Zero.
Darnold on first down. Being chased out left. And taking it to the 15.
Why are we not getting them? My God.
The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts. As they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. To throw is Darnold. And this is caught. Well, they get one back.
Oh, my God.
Picking up the late touchdown here, but still down big.
Got hurt.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team. But I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film. But this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
And
And there's going to be a stoppage here. The booth wants to take another look at this potential touchdown.
Going on.
It took them an extra look, but they found out it is a touchdown indeed. The official says this one counts. And he gets it to go to make this a 35-10 score now. So that one, an 8-play drive. It spans 75 yards. And it ends with a Jet touchdown. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be out of bounds here just past the 20-yard line.
At their own 22-yard line.
Now this Broncos offensive unit ready to head back out onto the field. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week.
It got his man complete. And he finally goes down at the 23-yard line.
That's good.
A huge play there for Denver. 55 yards.
First and 10 at the 23-yard line.
So this one will wind up a Denver victory. And when you break it down, you know, this was just a thoroughly dominating performance.
And I truly thought that we'd have a tight game coming into this one.
Yeah, no tight game. Yeah. You were wrong.
After the production.
You were wrong. There's no tight game. No tight game. Type game. All right, guys, it's been fun. I love you. I'll start streaming more, but let's get out of here. Let's go raid somebody. Bye bye.